Greetings and blessed day to you once again, people of God. It's the Revelator once again. And hoping the grace and mercy of our Lord Jesus Christ is with you until the end of time. We are meeting once again in yet another informative dimension inside the Word of God, praying that the knowledge and the wisdom of the understanding of the Word is ushered inside your understanding, for the benefit of your spirit and soul. Today, I want to take you into a very unique presentation, a presentation that I've been praying before I came before you, so that the Holy Spirit can usher and influence me and inspire me to teach before you. Today, I want to present the titled presentation, endorsements. It is imagined that in this world a lot want to be endorsed, not by God but by men. They want the motivation of men. They want to subscribe to men so that whatever they are doing, might it be a calling, might it be any great work that inspires humanity, they are seeking for the approval of men instead of getting an endorsement from God, who is the giver of all gifts and talents. Now, as I promised, endorsements. Let's go to the book of Matthew chapter 11 verse 2. Now when John had in the prison the works of Christ, he sent two of his disciples and said unto him, are you the one that should come, or we should look for another? This is John the Baptist, who has been in prison ever since the one that he has been waiting for came. And the one that he has been waiting for was none other than the Son of God, who is Jesus. But what is mysterious is that, John, you are sending two of your disciples to go and inquire to Jesus, from Jesus, if he is the one or not. But this is the one on whom the scripture, on whom the vision and the voice and the confirmation came from above, saying on the one on whom the dove will descend, he is the one. You already got that confirmation, John. And I'm talking about John the Baptist. You already got that confirmation that confirmed that this was Christ, the one that you have been a forerunner for, preaching the word, preaching the coming of Christ, the one that would baptize many, not through water as you were doing, but the one that would graduate souls into the level of the baptism of fire. And you even heard a voice coming down from heaven. And the voice that you heard coming down from heaven was also another confirmation, which said, this is my beloved Son, in whom I am well pleased. Now, after hearing all these confirmations, did you approve them as enough endorsement that confirms that this was? Did you approve all of these as enough endorsements that confirm again and again that this was the Son of God. No, you didn't. Now that you are locked in prison, you are now doubting if the one that truly called you has truly also called you because of the circumstances that you are now going through. You are now in prison and you are asking yourself, is this part of my calling? How did I get in this situation if this is part of my calling? But you need to understand that the one that endorsed your calling is the one that has already come. And the reason why you endorsed the one that has already come before he had come is the reason why you have been persecuted. Why? Because the one that endorsed you is the one that sent you to endorse him. You don't start by endorsing yourself. You have to endorse the one that called you, so that the one that called you can endorse you. People are fighting for endorsement in this world. In a presentation that I once shared, I explained how people are fighting so that they get approved. But they are fighting for that approval from the wrong sources. John the Baptist has been given more than one proof, more than one evidence, multiple voices of evidence, multiple significant proofs that endorse that the one that has already come is the Son of God, who is none other than Jesus. But still, he sends two of his disciples. And these two disciples that he has sent, he sends them to inquire, are you the one that should come, or we should wait for another? I've noticed that you have a doubt of who you are just because it was revealed who you are. From the very day that I revealed who you are, the devil has made sure that he confuses who you are. From the very day that I revealed who you are, the devil has taken it upon himself to disturb who you are. From the very day that I revealed who you are, the devil has come to oppose who you are. From the very day that I confirmed the voice that approves who you are, the devil has come to oppose the endorsement that came from above. Now, John the Baptist then sends two of his disciples, and they go and they went and reached out to Jesus. Now, when they went to where Jesus was, they found Jesus preaching. Why? Because he was already doing what his father had endorsed him to do. They found Jesus in the middle of a sermon presentation. Now, I need you to understand something. This one that is now preaching is the word. He does not need a man to be endorsed. And the reason why he sent John the Baptist was not that he gets endorsed by John. It was because he wanted to announce his arrival. He wanted to be announced before his coming. And he is found by John's two disciples preaching. And then the disciples of John start asking, we have been sent by John, who has been locked away in prison. The John that has been preaching about you, the John that has been marketing your coming, he is the one that has sent us. And he is so concerned. He wants to know, are you the one that we have been waiting for, or we should wait for another? Why? Because right now our master is behind bars, and he has been preaching about your coming, and here you are. And all along we thought that you are going. Our master is trapped, and all this time we thought that you are going to come as an angel from above with mighty strength, with power to rescue all those that are afflicted, to deliver all those that are oppressed, to rescue all those that are locked up like our master. But rather you are just preaching the word. And there is no supernatural dimension that you are experiencing out of everything that you are doing. Is it possible that you are the one, or it may be possible that you are not the one? We need to know, so that we go back to John and let him know that the one that you have been waiting for is not the one, or the one that you have been waiting for is the one. But if you are the one again, it needs to be confirmed. These men, the way that they have been sent, they have been sent to confirm if the one they've been sent to is really the one. Why? Because they expected Jesus to be operating at a dimension of a superhero. They expected an angel, they expected a supernatural being who would come to destroy and distract the opponent. Yet they did not understand that Jesus had not come to destroy, to kill, or to destroy evil systems, but he had come to announce himself and to spare those that are afflicted by their own sin. Now, after the disciples of John had been given the answer, you need to understand how they were given this answer. Then Jesus answered and said unto them, go and show John. Then Jesus said, go and show John these things that you see and hear. Meaning that he gave a message, a specific message, not in form of words. But he started demonstrating miracles, signs, and wonders. And when he was demonstrating miracles, signs, and wonders, he was demonstrating a level that is beyond endorsements, but a level of endorsement that does not need any man to endorse him. There is a level of being endorsed by heaven to the level that you don't need to speak, so that people get approved. A level that does not need men to approve you, but a level that needs proof, so that you get approved without any word coming out of you. He started healing the sick, the blind received their sight, the lame walked, the lepers were cleansed, the deaf started hearing, and the dead were raised up, and the poor were given the gospel. This he said while he's demonstrating. And after demonstrating, he then told John's disciples, saying, go back and show John these things that you saw and the things that you heard. Sometimes when we talk about endorsement, what is required is not what you only heard, but what you saw. Sometimes when you talk about endorsements, people don't just want to hear your words, so that it is proven that heaven endorsed you. Sometimes when you talk about endorsements, what is required is not just your actions, but the type of word that you preach. And Jesus demonstrated all these categories. And after demonstrating all these categories, he then released John's disciples and told them to go and relate the message back to their master who was behind bars, so that he could get comforted and he would get total assurance that the one that he had been a forerunner for was surely the one. What has approved Jesus there was not just words. I want to repeat this. What has approved Jesus there is the way that Jesus, and how does Jesus operate? Jesus does not only speak, he acts. But we are now in a world where people want to be endorsed by men. Why? Because they have little to show in terms of proving who they are. But they have more to speak. They have more to speak, more than they have more to prove. Now, when you don't have more to prove in terms of action, you are in danger. And you endanger other lives. Why? Because you are not substantive in your words. You are not having a concrete ground in whatever you are preaching. And you are not certain in what. The problem with many is that they want to be endorsed for nothing. The problem with many is that they want to be endorsed without proving themselves. The problem with many is that they now want to be approved by the church. They want to be endorsed by the church, not by God. The problem with many that have callings is that they now announce their callings unto men. They no longer want their callings to be announced by God. The problem with many is that they don't allow their callings to be proven by God. The problem with many is that they don't want the one that endorsed their callings to operate on their own behalf. The problem with many, they want their families to endorse them. The problem with many is that they want to go against the one that endorsed them. The problem with many is that they don't want the one that endorsed them to lead, so that he can prove himself in their callings. All that they do is to want to please men. In your quest of wanting to please men, have you since realized that the one that is meant to endorse you is no longer with you, and the one that is meant to endorse you is no longer with you? Who then are you now working for? Why? Because you did not call yourself. You were called by him that should endorse you. Therefore, if the one that is meant to endorse you is no longer present, who then is now your endorsement? Is it men? And if it is not men, it can only be the devil. I want to pray for you today, child of God, in whatever you are doing. I want to pray for you so that you get endorsed by God today and not by men. You are given the strength by the Holy Spirit, the motivation and the influence by God. You are strengthened by God. You are not shaken by men. You are not disapproved by men, but you are endorsed by men. In the name of Jesus.
And darkness tries to hide and trembles at his voice, trembles at his voice. How great our God, see with me how great our God.